Hi everyone, John Dickinson here to share with you what's new in Particle Illusion 2023.5. And in this version, we've given you a mix of features that will boost your creativity, as well as making you more productive when working with Particle Illusion. So let's start with the creative features in this version. And the one I've had the most fun working with building examples for this release is particle masking. And in particle masking, you can use a layer, and this is in the plugin version of Particle Illusion, to mask the particles in different ways. Let's take a look. Now, I'm using Particle Illusion here in After Effects, and I've got two layers. I've got my Particle Illusion layer and this glow text, and I'm going to use the glow text as the mask for the particles. Now, with the Particle Illusion layer, here I've got a big area of particles, and this is created using a plane emitter. And the reason I'm using a plane emitter is because I can scale it to encompass all of the letters of the mask. But you can actually use any emitter with particle masking. So up here in the effect, to apply particle masking, I'll just twirl open particle masking. And under Use Mask 4, there's a couple of options. There's particle creation and a couple of render mask options. So first of all, I'll choose particle creation. And under Mask Particles, you can see by default, it's set to With Layer, but you can also use Pixel Chooser to act as a mask as well. We'll look at that in a moment. Now under Mask Layer, I'll change that from None to Glow. And straight away, you can see now my text is emitting particles. And because I've chosen Particle Creation, the particles are born and then they can move beyond the particle mask. Very nice. Let's look at the next option, which is Render Mask Standard. And this will create a standard compositing mask. You can see how that masks the particles out, and we can no longer see them beyond the edges of the mask. And of course, you could create this in After Effects, but this is actually quite handy if you plan to render directly out of Particle Illusion, for example. Very nice. Now, the next option is Render Mask Full Particles. I'm just going to zoom in to the edge here. And notice what happens to the particles when I choose this option. So the particles are masked out, but they're not cropped off. So we can see the full particles at the edge of the mask. But as with Render Mask Standard, you don't see them beyond the mask. Particles are born in the area of the plane emitter, and they can move into the mask area and be visible, and then move beyond the mask area and be invisible again. So this is acting as a true mask of the particles. And once we have that set up, of course we can go back into Particle Illusion and we can play around with different emitters and different particles. So I'm going to just deactivate this pixie dust one by double clicking. And I'm just going to turn this one on by double clicking. And this has got some flowers and some leaves. You can see now inside Particle Illusion, because we've turned on particle masking, we can see a preview, and that looks really interesting, doesn't it? So I'll apply that, and of course, once that is set up, I can go and adjust the mask, I can change the text, and it will update automatically. So I'll just type in grow, which seems more suitable, and you can see that's already updated, and that's ready to go. So cool. It's so great to be able to finally emit particles from masks and from text in this way. Now, the other option I mentioned is with Pixel Chooser, and this is using Continuum's powerful Pixel Chooser options. So I'll just go back to Particle Creation, and I'm going to choose with Pixel Chooser. And by default, we don't see anything. So we'll come down to Pixel Chooser and turn Pixel Chooser on. Now, you can use a variety of options in Pixel Chooser. You can use masks and mats. Under mask, if I just turn on shape, you've got different kinds of shapes, things like egg. And you've even got gradient options where you can fade out the particles. And of course, you've got the on-screen heads-up display where you can adjust the shape of the Pixel Chooser. Now, the other option is mats. And I'm going to use a different example for this one. I've got this shot of a young boy in a cape acting like a superhero, and I want to have these particles emit from just the red cape and the red mask. So I can use Pixel Chooser under the matte settings. If I choose, for example, key, and then I choose the color I want to emit from, I'm just going to borrow that one for color B. And now we're just emitting from those red pixels. So just from the mask and, you know, from this part here and from the cape itself, which is really nice. It's so great to be able to use Pixel Chooser in this way to really finally control where your particles are emitted. Another great new creative feature is Draw Trails. And this is a new option added to the Lines category for particles. I've had particular fun using it, creating examples for this release, just using the new particle masking tools we just looked at. And it's super easy to use. You can see I've got a fairly simple simulation here, and it can actually make any particle simulation look better. Check this out. With the particle node selected, if I just check Draw Trails, that adds a trail to each of the particles. So nice and so fast. I can make adjustments to things like trail length. I can even fade or taper the trail. Let's just bring that taper right up. Very nice. And maybe just some fade. It's super responsive and just makes any particle simulation look better. And of course, it's also 3D because Particle Illusion is a 3D particle generator. If I just select my emitter and rotate that, you can see the lines also are affected by the rotation. Very nice. Other new enhancements for non-trail lines include a new lines fade option. In this example here, we have this classic starburst look. And sometimes you get that really bright area at the middle, and that's what lines fade has been designed to manage. Just come down and increase lines fade to 100. Notice how that's now faded out. If we make that minus 100, then the ends of the lines fade out. And there's also a new size, scales, thickness option as well. If I bring it up to 100, then the particle's line will scale based on the size of the particle. Let me just bring lines fade just back to maybe 50. And now you can see the small particle there has a thin line and the larger particle's line is slightly thicker. So some great new creative options when working with lines. I use force objects all the time in Particle Illusion, and they've been essential for me to create these kind of text to dust looks that I've done in the past. But in 2023.5, they're now much easier to create thanks to the addition of turbulence inside of forces. Here's a typical setup, and notice how the force is pushing the particles, but the particles have no turbulence. Now, in the past, I would have used, just select the force, I would have used a box grid, and I would have just changed the strength variation and the direction variation. And you can see how that breaks the particles up, but it's kind of sort of breaking them up into chunks. And then I would have had to apply other various settings and use different forces to make that look more organic. And of course, I could have added some fluid dynamics as well, but fluid dynamics are now kind of unnecessary for this now that we have force turbulence. So I'm going to bring that back to my box and check this out. If I increase direction turbulence, I'm going to bring it right up to 100, and look at that. So now we've got that beautiful turbulence that we've already had in Particle Illusion, but we're using it with forces. So that's giving 100% direction turbulence. If I change that to 50, then we've got a combination of the original movement and the direction turbulence. And of course, I've got various options for turbulence, including things like frequency. Just bring that right up. We get a lot more detail to that. And also auto-evolve options. So you can see how much easier that is to create. When I originally created this look for Particle Illusion a few years ago, I had like 6 forces in there to try and move the particles around. But now it's just one option, direction turbulence. Really nice. Deflectors have also had an update in 2023.5, making them true 3D objects. You can see I've added one into the scene here. I've got my camera orbiting around that, and notice how it's only affecting some of the particles. I can adjust that with the new depth option. If I just increase the depth, Now all of the particles are hitting that deflector in 3D. Very nice. There's also new 3D orientation controls. And we've also fixed leaking and bouncing, so you'll find that much more predictable now. So if you've been avoiding deflectors, definitely worth giving them another look in 2023.5. Now, you probably won't use deflectors in every project, but one thing you definitely will use is color. And to make that easier, we've added big improvements to both the color gradient editor and the alpha gradient editor, including the addition of presets. And one way to view the editor is just to double-click on the gradient on the node. So this is the color gradient editor. And to load a preset, simply click Load Preset and choose from one of the factory installed presets. Once you've found something you like, just click Apply, and you can also make various adjustments. There's things like flip and space and even a random option where you can just cycle through different random looks. Once you've found something that you like, you can fine tune it by using these sliders. And once you have something you're happy with, just click Save Preset. And if I go and click Load Preset now, you can see there's my new preset. And all of your personal presets are indicated by the yellow dot. If you've decided that you don't like what you've got, you can just click Revert, and that will go back to the original gradient. It's the same setup for alpha gradients. Just double-click the gradient, and the same kind of features in here. Click Load Preset. In the preset window, both the color gradient and the alpha gradient have these sliders, and you can use these to customize how these swatches look. I actually prefer mine quite small, like they are in Photoshop and Illustrator. We've also added some great time-saving presets for particles over life parameters. Here you can see I've got this grass just scaling up over time. And if I click on size over life, here's my graph down here. See, it's just a basic linear graph. If I click on load, we've got a bunch of factory presets. I've got this one here, which I think will work well. This is one that's already been created by me. Click apply, and now we can get very quickly a much more effective look for this grass where it bounces up and down again. So a great time saver using the overlife presets. Nodes have also received some new functionality in 2023.5, and that includes a new context menu. If I right click here, there's the menu, and from here I can choose a new solo option. And this option makes working with these kinds of multi-particle emitters much easier. You can also double click on a node and give it a name. And while that's not new, notes are new. If I unlock, I can leave a note for this one. Click apply. And up here in the top right hand corner of the node is a little tooltip with that node popping up when I roll over it. And there are dozens of additional improvements that make working with particle illusion much, much easier. And don't forget to take a look at the presets that take advantage of many of these new features. So that's a quick look at some of what's new in Particle Illusion 2023.5. To learn more, visit borisfx.com, where you can also download a free trial version. For now, this is John from Boris FX. I'll see you in the next tutorial.